So good morning, everybody. Afternoon, actually. Said I'd come down and see if I could catch a fish today. Got a carp or something just jumped up out there. And I'm gonna see what I can come up with here. Starting out with the H2O lipless crankbait in the section shed. 5/8 of an ounce. Let's see what I can come up with. Got it paired up here on the Shimano. Extra heavy. 7'6" along with my Edwin Garcia Max Size. Not gonna guarantee I can catch anything.
Lovely.
Well, how about that?
Right off the bat.
Hey, not bad either. First cast. I love it when that happens. Let's see if we can hold him on. He's a decent size one. He's not a mega bass or anything like that, but ain't bad either. Get you on up here. Hey, whoa, well, buddy, I don't know if that counts or not, but you know, these little hooks, that's the only thing on the H2O. They come with smaller hooks and they're pretty simple to change out. I just prefer to fish them the way they come. Let me try that again. First cast, first bass, and falls off the hook. Story of my life here lately. I mean, I hooked into a nice one down at the other pond that, or one of the other spots that we fish at, and somebody had some line in the water, that braided line, and I don't know if I lost him before I got to the braided line or if I lost him when I got to the braided line. Point is, I lost him. Kind of hurt my feelings a little bit. That was a nice fish. Gary and Adam both got a look at him. They said he was probably in the 3 to 5 pound range. Gary said 5 pounds, Adam said 3 to 5. And Adam's like me, he kind of tends to guess the weight a little small, so, you know, give a little bit of a margin of error there. Fishing with 12 pound tests. Nice wind blowing behind me here. Like 15 mile an hour wind today, I think it is, maximum. I don't know, something like that. A little red-eared sunfish down there. I don't know if you'll ever see them there. Down there. can't catch fish here. I usually catch majority of my fish here to start out with. Maybe not today. I might have a 2-pounder here. We'll just have to take a look and see, huh? One of the nicest bass I've ever caught here. I don't think that's the one that got off either. At him. Maybe a pound and a half, but I'm going to put him on the scale because this will be the size of the fish that I have to beat today since it's the biggest one. Make sure I'm recording. I don't even know if I am or not. Yep, I am. How about that? Alright. Scale is weighed out at 0. Get you on the scale here, buddy. See where you're at. You are at, well, I said 1.5, and it's at 1.4. I'm going to get down here and get you back in the water. So, thanks for biting, buddy. One of the prettiest fish there is, I think. Prettiest freshwater, anyway. A little sip of my Mountain Dew here. Haven't had a Mountain Dew in a long time. Ah, yeah. perfect one, but well, this is the size that I normally catch here. All right. Number two landed. Just a half a second, and he grabbed it. I don't think he's as big as that other one that I caught down here. If he's even still on there, I don't know. Sharp too, buddy. See too many turtles in here, honestly. Thank you. So I think I'm gonna move. I'm gonna turn the camera off so you guys don't have to be bored with my footsteps or walking along the sidewalk. But before I move, before I turn the camera off, I am gonna throw this little Texas rig right down here. See what I can come up with. Who knows, I might catch fish. This is the what is this? This I think, yeah, this is a young dinger. Thank you. cage any bigger than the other one, but I just want to see. I mean, I know I'm not catching giants here, so don't take it the wrong way, but I just like to see how much they're weighing when I'm catching them. The other one was 1.4, and this one is just 15 ounces, so he's just under a pound. My yum dinger is laying right there. Wonder if I can get it. When you get old, you have to get down on your hands and knees sometimes. Yeah, pretty much destroyed, but it'll be good for a wacky rig or something. Over here, I got another yum dinger right here, though. See how shiny that thing is. They put it in, I guess, a scent. gone through this once before right here. Stick or a rock or something down there that you hang up on. had a bluegill and he was too small to get the worm up in his mouth. Catching these little guys. See, you know, it's more fun when you catch a big one, of course, but I'm not going to complain too much about catching a dink. See, the real part about fishing is, for me anyway, I don't know about the rest of you guys out there. Big fish for me are few and far between. I mean, yes, I target monster bass. I target the big ones. But it doesn't always happen the way you want it to happen. Especially when you're filming. It always seems to me like... that's a decent one. Yeah, okay. It always seems to me like when you're... when I got my camera on, this is when the big fish hit. And I lost that worm too, so he must have tore that up pretty good. Anyway, just out of man. There you go. He's not the biggest one in the world. Got some blood on his tail there, so it looks like he may have been, might have been guarding that. The nest. Might have been on a bed. tell you that you need wacky rig hooks, or you need a different type of hook other than the worm hook to catch fish on a wacky rig. So I'm going to say that if they tell you that, and you want to tell them you're full of crap, you saw house on fishing with house catching like that, then go right ahead. I don't think there's any harm in doing that. It's starting to cloud up. Pretty deep out in here, that's why I just take my time. I let my line go slack there. And when my line goes slack, I know that I'm on the bottom. There's a bite. I don't think I got it though. No, if I did, he was small. He probably felt that hook and says, yeah, I don't want that. Yeah. Out there a little bit deeper this time. Sits here for a second or two. stick. Had to be a stick. Also known as a warmouth. He's a pretty good size there. He's bigger than my hand, it looks like. Get an idea. Yeah. These are nice, all pretty. See it or do I don't? At this point, I don't. I think I got in my pocket here. I don't have anything in my pockets that I can use, so I have to go back to the tackle box. Sometimes I pick up a soft plastic that I got laying on the counter or something like that. guess that'll count as one. I'll take it. I'm not going to complain too much. I'm going to look at my battery life and see if I need to plug in my battery pack. And it looks like I do. So I changed places. What was it, that park bench over there? Not that far, maybe 50 feet or so. So that right there is pretty shallow, and it goes out. It's like a little sand. You see, it's got all kinds of timber laying down in here. So probably the smart thing to do would be to grab a spinner bait or something like that. But I caught some decent fish today. I just got another one. Not a big one, of course. Oh, look. Well, that could have hurt. Drew a little blood on myself there. Imagine that. Well, it could be worse, I guess. Talking about right here, he's got some fishing line down his throat, and can't tell if he's got like a lure in there or what, but I'm gonna, I guess, just leave it there. I don't know. There you are, buddy. And what that comes from is, it's like maybe somehow he might have got tangled up in some brush or something, and it broke somebody's line while he had a lure in his mouth. And when that happens, well, sometimes they'll be swallowing the lure. Could be a hook down in there that, you know, somebody didn't want to, he swallowed the hook, and somebody didn't want to hurt him, so they left it in there, so yeah. been nothing really, really big. Four has been my biggest one. Take this guy or caught some small four have been that big. Okay, there you are, guys. And now I need to see if I can read this text that I got. It's probably from my daughter, or it might be from Adam, or it might be from my wife. So somebody go look and see. Camera off for a second. Alright, so I'm back. Coming back down here to my pole. Holes and my supplies. Just watching the weather. I know y'all can't hardly hear me over the wind, but one suggestion I have is if the wind bothered you, you can turn off the volume and maybe see if my closed captioning picked up. Move down a few more yards. Caught some nice fish here, some nice fish over there, some nice fish down the other way. Fished. too much right here. And there's the shallowness I was telling you about. So I might come over here, lay my stuff down and put a worm on. See if I can catch a worm fish. Size weight that is, probably not very heavy at all. I do know I've got a 5-odd hook on here. And there's no little trying to think of the word. No little spot to put your hook in on these like there is on the young dinger. So what you have to do, once you get the worm in the right spot, the hook in the right spot in the worm, you have to like skin hook it. You don't have to, but that just helps you stay a little more weedless. Like I said, I've never really fished right here too much. I have with a moving bait, but never with a worm. There's a bass going right there. So. Oh, yeah, I got him too. Yeah, about that. It's like you saw that one going out there. And he ain't bad either. Not a bad size at all. But that thing hit the water, and he actually, like you saw it flying through the air and went after it. Yeah. There you are. Nice little bass. Thanks, buddy. That was nice. Alright. Bill Dance says, if you think you're fishing too fast, slow down. Think you're fishing too slow, slow down. Sorry, Bill. Didn't mean to misquote you there. Dinker, dude. Ow, you little shit. His hooks are sharp. You know, right? Man. Again, it's brand new, just got it a couple days ago. It's the one that I broke that I'm replacing. It's the Angler Asset Profit Spinnerbait. One heck of a bait, I tell you. So I'm gonna get my pliers here and get these staples out. And then I'll be back. So I've got it tied on. Beautiful spinner bait. It's the Angler Assets Profit. It's in the 1/2 ounce. I also have a white one called the Blue Shad. But this one is the gilly, or bluegill. It does catch fish. The white one will catch fish. This one will catch fish. I don't know if it'll catch them today, but as a rule it does, especially at this place. If I don't get it hung up on something, I'll be all right. got one there. Oh yeah. Nope, that was a tree. That was a tree. Well, it felt like a fish though. Be a spinnerbait day, but I thought with the wind it surely would be. No reason to try to catch the carp. He's not going to be catchable. And I wouldn't want to anyway. But I can come right out here from this little rock. Thank you. no bites up in here. Wow. That's odd. I usually get a bite up in here right off the bat. Big one, but it is one unless it's a stick. Wow, how did you hook? Wow. Too hard to fish up there. Yeah, on that side anyway. Temperature's starting to drop pretty good. Cold front moving in. Cold fronts equal storms. Probably have better luck back down there where we're at. And right here is only only caught one fish since I've been down here. See anything biting here. Changed up baits a little bit. I've got myself a Berkeley call shad 6-inch. So we're gonna see how that does here. For right now, I don't like this. But that doesn't mean once I start throwing it a little bit more that I won't. So I'm going to change up to a fire tiger here. The storm doesn't look ominous or anything like that, but clouds or whatever you want to call it, but it does look like I might get wet here pretty soon, so I might have to call it a day here pretty quickly. Temperature dropped. It was 75 when I got here. I want to say it's about 70 right now. Not bad. Change the color of my lipless to I guess a fire tiger. I don't know. I'm gonna give it a try. I've had it for a long time and he's never used it. We'll see. Fourth catfish out of here, guys. Fourth catfish. Wow. That little booger, too. Yes, sir. Pissed too, aren't you? Yes, sir. you're bitching. I don't blame you. Boy, you are slick. You are slick. I'm trying not to get stabbed here. So my biggest so far has been 3.2. Come on, get up in there. Get up in there. Like those lipless crankbaits. Multi-species day. Thank you. didn't notice it before. As I was hooking this thing up, I realized the back hook only has two prongs on it, so it had three on it, I believe, when I started out, but I think maybe that catfish, maybe it might have a little prong left in it. Seeing some rain falling over there. camera on while I walk to the vehicle, so that you guys can get a look at what I see coming. All right, over there is a big rain cloud dropping rain somewhere. Don't look as bad as what I thought it was gonna look. Like that back there doesn't look real good.